Hi, I'm Nuha and I'm with Sadek. We're in Prismic Studio. And we wanted to answer a question that we hear a lot, which is, when I create a website, how do I choose which technologies to work with? How do I choose my tech stack?
Right. And, you know, it's an important question and it comes so often because there are so many solutions, so many technologies. Like people ask, like, should I use WordPress? Should I not use WordPress? There are so many other choices, like about frameworks, like, you know, React, Gatsby, JavaScript, Node.js or others, mm-hmm. you know, and each of these have its own advantages. And that's why knowing these advantages, knowing your context, then you can decide better. So yeah. That's why maybe we thought of doing this video to kind of go into the advantages and of the different approaches.
And yeah, the answer that we tend to give first is related to like who you are. Who are you?
Right.
If you're a developer or not, or a designer.
Right. If you are, so if you don't know how and you don't want to learn how to write JavaScript and CSS, so maybe you are looking for some like website visual builder where you have some interface, you know, you drag and drop some blocks to get your website. Of course, it's constrained, but maybe for your use case, you don't want to invest time learning. So that's an approach. It's not the approach that we're going to talk about in this video. We're more focusing on people that can write some HTML and CSS. Mm-hmm. So for the other people that can do that, there is so basically there are two different blocks, right?
Yeah.
There is the code or the templates that kind of render the website, mm-hmm. and there is the content. Where does it go? Where do you host it? How do you edit it? Right? Because of course you can do a website without managing content, then you will have that as you know, static, mm-hmm. But you don't want to go committing, changing your code and redeploying it each time you have to fix a typo.
Yes.
It's not a very good, you know, it takes a lot of time and it's not a very productive approach.
Yes.
So it's better to imagine it as two different blocks. Right?
Okay.
You know, one that renders and one that manages content, which has like an editor and, you know, all the different things that you need to publish content.
Okay. And then you have two choices. Either you choose a solution where you have those two blocks coupled, WordPress, for instance, or you could use two different solutions, like have your own framework and your own CMS.
Right.
And then like use
So them. These different, for instance, the traditional solutions will have these both coupled. But the problem with that is you're constrained to mm-hmm. what that CMS technology provides you. So you'll have to, for instance, WordPress to write inside WordPress templates.
To add plugins,
all these kind of things, which is a good approach. There are a lot of things that we can learn from WordPress. They've done a great job. They have a huge community. But, you know, you can't choose your favorite technology or frameworks from these that are evolving a lot. The other thing is I say, okay, well, what I need the CMS for is just the publishing and the editor.
Mm-hmm.
And then I want to be able to, you know, use my favorite framework, JavaScript framework or whatever it is, PHP framework, and, you know, to develop with that. So that's another approach. So, yeah. And then there is the choice between these technologies and these CMSs
the CMS,
that need to be approached.
And you talked about the community, and that's also maybe something that can help you choose when you consider technology. Like the technology around the community around it.
Yeah, is there a big community around something? Because, you know, you don't want to be stuck with something that doesn't have a technology. Because in case you have questions or you have, you know, issues or you're using it not in the way that they thought about it.
Yeah.
You know, you need to be able to have someone else that has thought of it or developed something for it or gave an answer about it.
Or you can ask and you know that you're going to have like an answer really quickly.
But how can you know like what how big the community is?
Well, when it's about the community, most of people would look at their GitHub and see how many stars do they have or the number of questions answered. Like
in StackOverflow and things like this.
But I like the idea of having like a Slack community or a
Spectrum community where, you know, you can ask questions.
You can interact. Yeah.
With chat. And I had a friend, he used to go to Google and just Google like the name of the technology issue. And then he will see how many issues they have in this community and are they solving them?
Yeah.
Or, you know, are they responding to these people?
Just to test it out.
Yeah.
Okay.
So maybe in future videos, we'll talk about how to choose a framework
Yeah.
And then maybe we can, in another video, dig deeper into how to choose a CMS or something for managing content.
Yeah, sure.
Cool.